from man-made changes to severely threatened animal species. Here are 9 habitats that were ruthlessly destroyed. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 9. Arctic. Many have argued that the Arctic is ground zero for climate change, as temperatures in the region have increased almost twice the amount of the global average. It's worth mentioning that the connection between global warming and human activity at this point in time is undisputed by the scientific community. There is a scientific consensus on climate change that recognizes it's been heavily influenced by humans through the emission of greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide. The melting sea ice in the Arctic threatens species like the polar bear, which might become extinct in less than a century if current trends continue. As the vegetation on the tundra changes, reindeer and caribou could lose foraging areas. The rising sea levels could decimate nearly 50% of the nesting areas used by migratory birds. Feedback loops mean the Arctic is not only a victim of global warming, but also an active contributor. Because the ice that reflects sunlight is melting, the ocean absorbs more solar radiation and becomes hotter. As permafrost melts, more carbon is released into the atmosphere, warming the planet even further. The melting ice may also tamper with ocean salinity and destabilize oceanic currents. Number 8. Habitat destruction. A destroyed habitat is one that's no longer capable of sustaining its native species and ecological communities. Species can become displaced or permanently lost, thus reducing biodiversity. In fact, habitat destruction has been described as the dominant cause behind the extinction of species on a global scale. According to most studies, the number one reason for habitat destruction is clearing the land for agriculture. Other contributing human activities include logging, mining, trawling, or urban expansion. Habitat destruction isn't entirely man-made, as it also occurs naturally as a result of earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, floods, and climate fluctuation. However, in those situations, a habitat usually has a chance to recover, while the destruction from human activity occurs at a far greater rate and scale. Before we move on, answer this question. Which of these is the world's largest conservation organization? Is it A, Worldwide Fund for Nature, B, the Wildlife Conservation Society, C, the Nature Conservancy, D, the Sierra Club? Let us know what you think in the comments section below and stay tuned to find out the right answer. Number 7. Madagascar. Humans arrived in Madagascar about 2,350 years ago, and since then, the island has lost over 90% of its native forests. The earliest settlers brought with them slash-and-burn agricultural practices, the main driver of destruction. The practice is still in place today and is associated by the locals with health, prosperity, and religious tradition. Numerous species have succumbed to extinction since humans arrived there. These include the island's endemic elephant birds and several species of giant lemurs. Our arrival to the island also introduced dangerous invasive species, such as the Asian common toad. Number 6. Habitat degradation. Habitat degradation could occur as a result of human activities such as pollution, climate change, and the introduction of invasive species. This means that although the habitat is still standing, life is increasingly more difficult for its native plants and animals. The fast-growing human population is one of the reasons behind environmental degradation. Historically, there's always been a correlation between human expansion and the impact on native plant and animal species. This is essentially because more land is used for agriculture and urban development. Habitat degradation is also observable in the oceans, where years of pollution have increased their acidity. This can be seen in a number of coral reefs, habitats once bursting with life, that are now bleached and empty. Marine wildlife also faces the threat of man-made waste, such as plastics or chemicals, as seen in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Before we move on, official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. It's out of this world. Number 5. Mediterranean Basin. People have inhabited the Mediterranean shoreline for at least 8,000 years. The basin is home to over 22,000 plant species, half of which are reportedly only found there. Over 95% of the rich vegetation of the Mediterranean has been claimed by fires, deforestation, and grazing. Throughout the years, coastline development has increased tourism in the countries that share the sea's shoreline. However, this process has also wrought havoc on the local flora species. Human activity also threatens the Mediterranean lynx and the Mediterranean monk seal, which are the most endangered cat and seal species on the planet. Number 4. Habitat fragmentation. Fragmentation is the process by which wild areas are carved up into smaller pieces, thus reducing animal ranges and restricting their movement. It can occur as a result of natural processes, such as fires, volcanism, or floods, but also as the result of human activity. Habitats which were once unbroken become separated by pasture, pavement, croplands, or even barren land. The creatures that inhabit these regions are progressively forced into smaller areas, where they face the threat of extinction. This is particularly true for species of megafauna such as elephants, rhinos, or big cats, which require larger home ranges. Number 3. Tropical Andes. A stretch of land that accounts for roughly 1% of our planet's landmass is home to approximately 17% of all the plant life on Earth. The Andes are a mountain chain found on the South American west coast, stretching from Bolivia to Chile. They're also home to the spectacled bear, the only bear species on the Latin continent, and the critically endangered yellow-tailed woolly monkey. The Andes are also a significant source of natural resources, particularly oil and gas. This has led to the construction of pipelines and roads which traverse vulnerable ecosystems. River systems have been disrupted by hydroelectric dams and deforestation to make room for coffee plantations. This leaves numerous native birds without a habitat. Estimates indicate that the forest habitats in the tropical Andes are modified and destroyed 30% faster than in lower tropical regions. Number 2. Impact on humans. In rural areas, the impact of habitat destruction on the human population is more direct than in urban areas. A reduction in natural habitat is often correspondent to a reduction of natural resources available per capita. This also means that people in wealthier countries have to pay more to receive the resources that fuel their lifestyle. Deforestation in tropical forests increases the level of carbon dioxide that's released into the atmosphere, thus contributing to global warming. Plants and trees play an active role in climate regulation. By recycling rainfall through many flora and fauna species perform unique and valuable functions in the ecosystem. For example, some act as biological control agents for fungi, bacteria, and viruses. Habitat destruction also increases an area's vulnerability to natural disasters such as drought, flood, or water contamination. Even though there's an increase in food supply by the conversion of wild land to agriculture, it often comes at great cost. That same land could provide natural resources and services such as clean water or drought control. So which is the world's largest conservation organization? If you chose A, the Worldwide Fund for Nature, then you're right. Also known as the World Wildlife Fund, it's a non-governmental organization operating in more than 100 countries with over 5 million supporters worldwide and numerous ongoing conservational and environmental projects. Number 1. Borneo. In 2013, animal rescue workers captured a dramatic video in Borneo's Sungai Putri forest that shows an orangutan desperately fighting to defend his home. The video was released a few years later and included in a David Attenborough BBC documentary entitled Climate Change: The Facts. It's been described by many viewers as heartbreaking and as a tragic symbol of how habitat destruction is affecting animals worldwide. In the video, the orangutan can be seen running along a fallen tree towards the bucket of an excavator that's clearing a portion of the forest. The creature tries to fight the machine by hitting its bucket, but loses his balance as the mechanical arm is pulled up. The orangutan falls to the ground and circles back to the excavator, but logging workers ultimately chase him away. Fortunately, animal rescue workers were able to save the orangutan from harm and take him away to safety. Nevertheless, the video served as a startling reminder of the level of destruction that Borneo's forests are facing. The island, which is shared by Malaysia, Indonesia, and Brunei, has been severely impacted by both legal and illegal logging practices. Huge swathes of land have been cleared to make room for palm oil plantations. By some estimates, over 50% of the annual tropical timber acquisition comes from Borneo. Over the past 16 years, the orangutan population has more than halved as their habitats are destroyed and they're left to starve and die. Others are captured and traded illegally by wildlife dealers. Orangutans aren't the only animals that are under threat, as the island is also home to endemic species such as eastern Sumatran rhinoceros, Borneo pygmy elephants, and Bornean clouded leopards. Thanks for watching. What potential solutions to habitat destruction do you know? Tell us about them in the comments section below.